marks the correct behavior and releases them from the stay. And you're going to hear me using that throughout. The second would be our correction term, which is a no or a no, whether they do something wrong, basically, whether it's serious or minor, basically. So if they break the stay, I'll tell them no, and I'll take it back, and we'll do it again. But if they ever try to, like, jump up or try and steal something out of my hand, it's more of a firm correction. So we're going to hop right in with our manners now, and we're going to start with our gates and doorways. So you can see that he's in his crate right now, and anytime he comes out of the crate or through the door, I expect him to hold a stay. I shouldn't have to remind him. So we're going to bring him out. Expect him to hold a sit. way. Now, you're always going to have a table, you're always going to have a couch, those things you basically can't avoid having them in the reach of your puppy. And so that we work on replacing. And so you kind of have to see what he's chewing on. If he goes up to like your pillow and he starts chewing on it, quickly correct him and replace it with something kind of equal texture, because they're just looking for something to really dig their teeth into most of the time. Or if you see him go up to a table leg, you can give him something hard like this raw hide that they can chew on. So that's really the best, and you just swallow that whole, the best way to avoid the chewing, because like I said, for the first year, they just need to chew. Couple of his last manners. One would be jumping. And that's absolutely do not. Right? You don't want your dog to jump up on you or your kids or anything like that. And so we've worked a lot with that, because golden retrievers, they have a lot of energy. They like to move around. They like to jump and play. And so if he ever jumps up on you, the easiest way is to step into him. Make sure that they're not really getting that push off of you. Right? Because what they're doing when they jump, they want to get to your face. And so discourage that. Step into them. If you have to, you can bring up your knee just to prevent them from getting there. Never step backwards, or else that's going to encourage them to keep coming. Now, if you have someone in your family that maybe they see as an equal, they're going to want to play with more, kind of get after them. They might jump on them a little bit more. The best way to work with that is to take his leash as he approaches whoever it is, and when he tries to jump, do a little leash correction, which is about two pops on the leash, but never prohibit them from getting to that person, or else they're just going to want to go harder. And Jade here loves children, loves to play, and so that's one you might have to just practice if you have children. Let's see. Other of his manners would be drop him, and this actually treats us like a manner and a command. We have it in both sections, but just expecting him to drop on command. And so he loves his tennis ball most of the time, anyway. So we can get him to play here. Just going up over his nose. If it helps you to remember, that's the way we taught him to sit, is we'd take his food bowl and we'd lure his nose up until his hind end went down, and then we mark the behavior. Our second hand signal would be our down. And so I'll always put him in a sit first and then just take him down to the ground. Now if he just, when he stands up like that, chances are he won't go all the way down. good stay. Now I'll try and show you a down stay. Stay. Okay. Stays anywhere. We do it on the road, in the grass, but I like to do them a lot on his bed because it acts as a physical plane that he can't cross. And so if you use that, that's an easy way to build up his stays. And if you put him on a down stay on his bed, maybe when you have a downtime, like you're reading a book or watching a movie, you can easily build that up to 1 to 2 hours within the first year. And you do that by just starting, you know, he's a 30 seconds, build it up to 45 seconds, then a minute, then 5 minutes, and so on. If he tries to break, give him a little leash correction, and then bring him back and do it again, and then just shorten him a little bit. So, continue here. So he also knows how to go onto his bed on command. And so I'll put myself in a position close to the bed, and then he can just tell. Go to bed. Okay. Now, I don't care what position he is in, as long as all four paws are on the bed, and I'm fine with that. Also, when you put him onto the bed, expect him to stay until released. Okay. Next of our commands is his crate. So he'll also go in there with just the simple word, crate. Crate. just hit the bell to lick the peanut butter, but you're going to take him directly out to wherever you want him to use the bathroom. And I would walk around for about a minute or two, giving him the opportunity to go. Now, chances are he's not going to have to go. So you're going to bring him directly back in, and he's going to turn around and hit the bell again. So you're going to take him out, do the same thing, and then bring him right back in. And I do this about 10 times. Generally, within that 10 times, at 10 reps, he starts to pull, easy, you can just kind of give him a little leash correction and tell him easy. The other thing with that is never let him pull you anywhere. We have the saying, become a tree. So if he starts to pull, just plant your feet, give him a little correction and say easy, and expect him to turn around and give you that attention back. Now our other command is let's go, and that's just straightforward, just telling him we're going to move now. Now the other thing, I'm going to move him off the road, is with his leash training, we have two types of walks that we take him on. One would be his attention walk, so that's our, basically our business walk, getting from point A to point B. And so there you want him to focus on you and remain, or keep a J shape in the leash, just having it a slack leash. The second would be an off-leash walk or a long-leash walk. And that's just giving him the opportunity, easy, to be a dog, just to go out and sniff and to run around and play. So I'm going to show you his attention walk right now. We'll come back out on the road. And so just keep an eye on how he walks next to me and looks up at me. So I'll reward him every time. This takes some time, or it's a little bit harder to do because you often have a lot of treats on you. And that's just a firm it in. After a few months, those be solid and you won't have to reward him every time he looks at you. But where he's still a puppy and just getting the hang of it, I recommend treating him quite a bit. Let's go. See how he just continued to look up at me, and that's exactly what we want. You can also see when I stopped, he sat. That's another thing you want. That way he's not going to be tangling you up with the leash. The last part of our, I guess with the leash, is for the first, I would say a month or so, till you're really comfortable with him at your house, I would leave a short 4 or 5 foot leash on him. That way you can correct him if needs be, or if he's getting into something. The other thing is, until you're completely comfortable once again, if he's out at your house, out of the crate, or just out in the house, basically, make sure he's under 100% supervision. That way he's not going to find a corner and go to the bathroom or tear something up. So just make sure you follow through, and if you have any questions, feel free to call.